Sunday morning. Happy Mother's Day. Lord, we thank you for this day. We thank you for this day that we honor you and we honor the mothers you have created and fashioned with your own hands. So we ask your blessing on each and every one today. We ask your blessing on your church today, Lord. May your name be lifted high. May you be glorified and honored. We thank you, Lord, for being so faithful in our lives. So we look forward to what you have in store for us this day. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Happy Mother's Day to all of you that are listening, and God bless you. If you could like and share, that would be great, so more people can hear the Word of God today from Honeyville Baptist Church. worship Him wherever you are. Today, if you're listening and you don't know the Lord, or if you're hurting, I encourage you to reach out and just say, Jesus, I need you. Forgive me of all my sins. Come into my heart. I want to live for you. You are my Lord and my Savior. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you. Thank you. you are forgiven. Once you've asked Jesus into your heart and into your life, and you start living for Him, it's the beginning, not the end. For eternity. Precious name. Amen. Praise God. Boys and girls. Sorry about that. Hi, boys and girls. Today, I have a little game for you. But before I share the game with you, I want to show you this. Some of you have been sending in Flat Jesus adventures. And we're going to, this is the last day to send in your adventure pictures. And we're going to give out a couple of these to people that have been faithful and people that have sent in some unique pictures. So we have some of these to pass out. So send in your photos. Well, today, I hope you filled out your Mother's Day card and gave it to your mom. I have a scripture, and it says this in Psalm 119:11. It says, I have hidden your words in my heart that I might not sin against you. That's a very important verse. Every verse in the Bible is important. Every verse in the Bible is true. But with this verse, I thought today we could use a great sword drill. Now we're going to be, for VBS, doing a really unique Armor of God message through the Knights of North Castle. And on these little swords that I have Bible verses written. If you don't have swords, you can use popsicle sticks or whatever pieces of paper. But you can play this game with mom and dad or grandma and grandpa or friends that are with you at your home. But I put on here different verses of the Bible. And not only do I have that, but I have special surprises to get if you win. So what you do is you pull out a sword, and it says Nehemiah 4:13. And you hold your Bible shut, and then say Nehemiah 14. You repeat what the person that's saying it. And then you go, charge. And then you open up your Bible and look for that verse. And that's what you do with the different ones. And I put out some prizes here just for some ideas. I have some chocolate bars. I have some unicorns. I have some gum. I have some book markers. And I even have a hat. And I thought this would be cool for the person that did it the fastest for the ending of the game. So make yourself a game. Have some fun. Learn the Bible so that you won't sin against God. It's so very important. Let's pray together. Dear Jesus, I thank you for your word. And I thank you that it's true, that we can trust it and we can trust you. Father, I ask for each boy and girl that's listening that they will be able to hide your words in their heart so they won't sin against you. Lord, be with them. Let them feel your love and acceptance. And God, I ask you to put a seed of desire for you in each one of their hearts and minds. In Jesus' precious name, amen. Praise God. Amen. God bless you all.
Well, good morning, everyone. And once again, welcome to Honeyville. You know, we have a lot of, I know our church is tuning in. I've heard from a lot of you that tell me that you're watching, or you're watching every week, and by that I mean not only those who come to church here when we're able, but those that maybe haven't been able to in the past. So we welcome you, and we're so thankful that you're with us today. Happy Mother's Day. This is the day we honor our moms, our grandmothers, those that God has put in our lives. Now, I believe the Lord would encourage you today. First of all, let's take a look at Colossians chapter 1. And I want to go through that and see if you don't get hope from this scripture. Colossians chapter 1, verse 15. It says, Christ is the visible image of the invisible God. He existed before God made anything at all and is supreme over all creation. Christ is the one through whom God created everything in heaven and earth. He made the things we can see and the things we can't see. Kings, kingdoms, rulers, and authorities. Everything has been created through him and for him. He existed before everything else began, and he holds all creation together. Christ is the head of the church, which is his body. He is the first of all who will rise from the dead. So he is first in everything. For God in all his fullness was pleased to live in Christ, and by him God reconciled everything to himself. He made peace with everything in heaven and on earth by means of his blood on the cross. This includes you. You, who were once so far away from God. You who were his enemies, separated from him by your evil thoughts and actions. Yet now, he has brought you back as his friends. He has done this through his death on the cross in his own human body. As a result, he has brought you into the very presence of God. And you are holy and blameless as you stand before him without a single fault. But you must continue to believe this truth and stand in it firmly. Don't drift away from the assurance you received when you heard the good news. So the Bible clearly tells us that Christ is the visible image of an invisible God. That everything he did on the cross made everything possible for you and I today. That he made peace with everything in all of his creation through what he did on the cross. That you can stand before him today blameless and without a single fault because of what Christ did on the cross. But you must continue to believe this truth and stand in it firmly. Now there's a lot of forces that come against us. And sometimes it may be even be ourselves. There is a battlefield that wages within our mind. And there is an enemy that comes to steal, to kill, and to destroy. But God wants you to know today that he loves you. That he has made peace with you. He's made peace with you by what he did on the cross. But you must continue to believe this truth and stand firmly in it. Stand firmly. Even when something comes against you, even when the doubts come, even when the problems come, even when you don't feel worthy. So for the moms out there, and you can read this on your own, you'll find it in Proverbs 31. And I decided not to share that this morning because I believe the Lord led me to this particular scripture. The first thing that we need in this life is to know that we have peace with God. We need to know that we are forgiven, that we are loved. And that needs to happen in order for us to be able to do anything else effectively and successfully and consistently. So for the moms today, well, you all are, especially those of you raising your children today, those of you with your kids at home, little kids running around, and you are trying to do everything right now. You may still be trying to work. You're certainly trying to keep a household together. You're trying to raise your kids. You're trying to teach your kids. Everybody's homeschooling now. You're trying to pay the bills. You're trying to make the meals, clean the house, change the engine in the car, whatever it might be that you do. God would have you know today that he's with you and you're doing well. In this time we live in, I know some right within our congregation, some of you have now put up fences and you're raising pigs and cows and all kinds of things. And you're very, very busy. And sometimes very stressed. And sometimes we may even feel, get this, even completely inadequate. Maybe sometimes, and this isn't just for moms, sometimes we feel like we just don't measure up. But God has brought you back to him through what Jesus did on the cross. He's made peace with you. Now, Proverbs 3, 5 and 6, this is a very familiar portion of Scripture, says this, trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. Or in other words, do not depend on your own understanding. But seek his will in all you do, and he will direct your paths. In this world that we're living in today, it's tough to continue on day after day if we only lean on our own understanding. Because our understanding of the world and the way things work has all been thrown up in the air. And sometimes we begin to get fearful. I think that's the biggest thing that's going on right now is that a lot of us have become fearful. Certainly many of us have become isolated and feeling more and more isolated. And I want to encourage you to go to the Lord with this, and I'm serious about this, and pray. Pray against that isolation. That feeling, that spirit, whatever it is. Because we don't want to get used to this. I'm going to take a stand right now. We don't want to get used to this long term. Donna Jo and I have visited many of you. We have more to go. But it's everywhere we go now. You notice a difference. And there's a what we used to call a standoffishness, but now it's something that we do because we're supposed to. But I want to tell you something. The Lord didn't make you to just live isolated in your own little spot and never have any contact with anyone else. I used to think that he made me that way, and I found out through this that he didn't make me that way either. And I know he didn't make you that way. So don't get used to this. And I'm going to take a stand. I don't care if it shuts it down right now or not. Don't get used to this and don't accept this. I'm not telling you to be rebellious. I'm not telling you to go against the guidelines that the CDC and our state and federal and local governments have put on. I'm not telling you to do that. I'm just saying don't embrace it. Don't get used to it. Don't let it become our new normal. Because we need each other. And we are not made to be isolated. And I'll use this one little analogy, even though it's been used and overused over the years. But everyone understands that if you take a fire and you take the coals in a fire and you pull one coal away from the rest of the coals, it's going to go out. Fire's going to go out, it's going to turn cold, and it's going to die. We're built the same way. We need each other. And husbands, remember that the mom in your house, your wife, she needs you today. And wives, remember that your husband needs you too. Encourage and love each other. I came across something this week that reminded me to keep things in perspective. We're attached to our physical lives, our physical things. We're attached to our stuff. We're attached to the house we live in. We're attached to the car we drive. We're attached to our careers, our jobs. But do you know that God's love for you is not attached to any physical thing in this world. Which means this, and this is not something we want to have happen, but the whole thing could blow up tomorrow. The whole world could blow up tomorrow, and we could lose everything. We could be naked and cold and afraid with no house, no car, no clothes, no nothing. It would not change the fact that God still loves you. It might feel that way to you or I, but it doesn't change the fact that God still loves you. In the midst of these circumstances, in the midst of your circumstances, and for moms, in the midst of you struggling to try to keep a dozen different ends meeting together, God still loves you and He is with you today and always. His love is not attached to any physical thing in this world. I believe He blesses us with physical things and blessings and all kinds of things. But the abundant life that Jesus promised is not even based on the stuff that we have. We think of abundant life as success and the stuff that we accumulate and that we have and the security that we might find in all of that. God sees right through it and right past it and works right in the middle of it or even in spite of it. His love is not attached to any physical thing. So I would have you remember, and I believe God would have you remember today, know today, that He hasn't changed. His love for you hasn't changed. And He's with you. And no matter what happens, He will always love you. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. And lean not on your own understanding. Seek His will in all you do, and He will direct your paths. That's available to all of us today. That's available to every single person in the world today. What's available? God directing our paths. Being able to trust Him. Being able to depend on Him and lean on Him. Seeking His will in all that we do so that we have assurance that we are going in the right direction. And it's more important to seek His will before we go off in a direction than it is after we get there. I believe that Jesus has probably followed me into all kinds of places and situations that He really didn't want to go, but He went anyway. I think it's more important that we follow Him, even if we don't think we want to go there. Because His will and the path that He has for us is what will work the best for us. It's what will give us abundant life. It's what will give us the peace that we need so much. The peace that Jesus promised us, that passes all understanding, all what understanding? Our human understanding. So trust in the Lord. Lean on Him. And don't just depend on your own understanding. Because in our own understanding, we look at the situation that we're in and that the world is in right now, and we can easily get confused. We can easily get discouraged. We can easily get off track. Trust in the Lord. He has a plan in this. And I believe you're going to begin to see it unfold if you haven't already. And I believe the world, as we prayed for the other day, God's glory is going to spread across this earth. And it is going to be recognized by all creation. And that's a good thing. He has a good plan in store for you. Don't shy away. Don't, for those of you that are tuning in and you're just, maybe just, the Lord's speaking to you and you're catching on, so to speak. He's drawing you to Him. And maybe you've been tuning in every week now since we've been doing this. Or maybe you've tuned into 50 churches and you came across this one. And those of you who call Honeyville home and that tune in here every week, I want to encourage you to do something. I want to encourage you to get on the Facebook or on the YouTube, online, wherever you find it. But those are your two formats where you're going to find the most. And I want you to go and I want you to go to another church. Go to a dozen other churches and click those likes, just like Don Joe and some we ask you to do. That means so much to a pastor who's preaching to a camera. I ask you to encourage the other churches and encourage other pastors today or during the week when you are able. But for those of you who God is speaking to you, He's drawing you to Him. And He would have you know that you do not need to shy away from Him. You don't need to go back to the old familiar darkness, so to speak. Allow God to be God in your life and allow Him to bless you and allow Him to actually give you abundance. Allow His Spirit to just comfort and strengthen you. And in order to do that, we humble ourselves before Him. We repent of our sins. We ask for forgiveness. And as I've said before, you don't need me to point them out to you, and I don't need you to point them out to me. It's between you and God. It's between me and God. And He convicts me. The Holy Spirit shows me. Just as He shows you. Do you understand how that works? The Holy Spirit draws you. And He doesn't want to condemn you. He doesn't want you to feel beaten up. But He wants you to know that He loves you and accepts you. And that Jesus Christ on the cross did what He did to make peace between you and God. So that you can lean on Him, you can trust Him, and you can know that no matter the situation, there is victory in Christ. We have with us Marty Herman today, chaplain. Marty, and I've been looking forward to Marty being able to be with us here ever since, I think, the first week we went on the air. And be blessed. Works with you today.
The song the Lord laid on my heart today to do was written in 1922 by John Whitfield Vaughn as a tribute to his mother. It's called If I Could Hear My Mother Pray Again. So I'm using it 98 years later as a tribute to all of you moms out there who are blessed with the Lord and pray with your children. And I know all of you do.
If I could hear Pray again.
we're just going to pray. Did you know that the word sword in the Bible is 407 times? Isn't that amazing? And I had to say that so I could not cry before I started after that song, just to lighten the mood a little bit, because it reminds me, and I think there's a lot of you out there that maybe did not have your mom this year, or haven't had your mom or your grandma. And I know both my grandma and mom prayed for me, and they are in heaven today. And I hope that's the same for you. But if you're not praying for your child, your grandchildren, your neighbor's kids, kids that you see walk past you, pray for them. It's amazing what prayer can do and how prayer can bring Jesus into their lives. We have a praise. John has said that Sandy came through her operation, and she's doing well. So that's a praise. And we also have a prayer concern that Judy Brownell has lost her mom today, on Thursday. So please pray for that family and pray for Judy. And if you have a prayer request, would you please send it to us? We would love to pray and to lift up your family or your friends or your neighbors up to the Lord. So let's pray together and remember the people that we need to pray for, like Chausse with cancer. There's so many others with cancer and different things. And Kay's nephew, God, pray for him. There's so many. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we just thank you and praise you that nothing is too little and nothing is too great for you, and that you care about every need that we have, and that you want us to bring those needs to you. So, Lord, we lift each one of those prayer needs up to you, Father. And we ask you to be with our country, our president, the leaders, Father, the churches, the pastors, the leaders, Lord, the moms, the teachers, the rescue workers, the firemen, Lord, the people that are in the grocery store. Father, whatever, out on the pole for the phones and the electric, Father, the people that are sitting at their desks or sitting at home trying to work. We lift all those people up. We lift up them to see you, and that you be glorified in this situation, Father. We ask you to bring something good from this virus to this country, to this place, Father. In Jesus' precious name, we love you, Lord, and give you all the praise and thanks. Amen. Praise God.
And now may the Lord bless you and protect you. May the Lord smile on you and be gracious to you. May the Lord show you his favor and give you his peace. Thank you for worshiping with us today. God bless you.